here now for us. Explain chronic fatigue syndrome, define it, and then how does that differ from being tired all the time?
Well, thank you for asking. First, I'd like to ask in the audience, how many of you have heard of the term chronic fatigue syndrome before this conference? Oh, a lot of you. And how many of you heard the term myalgic encephalomyelitis before this conference? So the official name, myalgic encephalomyelitis, as hard as it is to say, commonly called chronic fatigue syndrome, we now call this ME-CFS. So it's not even called chronic fatigue syndrome anymore because it's such a horrible, horrible name. I mean, this illness is not chronic fatigue. It is a lot of different symptoms. So I wanted to define it to you somewhat today. Those of you are familiar with it. Unfortunately, some of you may have it or know of people who have it. But I wanted to define it to you a little bit, mainly because it validates the fact that this is really a biological disease. And if people know that, half the battle of being sick is knowing that, yes, this is a disease. This is a real biological disease. And there's hope out there for us to find treatment someday. So it really feels like you have, patients describe it as you have the worst flu you've ever had and you never got over it. Or you have a battery and it really is running out of juice. And when it has a little bit of juice, you try to do a little bit. Maybe you go out to pick up your kids that day and you end up losing all the rest of the juice of your battery and you now have a dead battery. So there's many, many symptoms with this disease, but it's, and there's, in a room full of patients, they may describe like 60 of them. One day we made a poster of those, and there literally were like 60 different symptoms. But the hallmark of these diseases and the way that the doctors basically clinically define it, it is prolonged fatigue, which is not relieved by rest. And unrefreshing sleep, which means that even if you slept 20, 21 hours a day, which some people do, unfortunately, you wake up and feel like you haven't slept at all. We call it unrefreshing sleep. And cognitive impairment is probably one of the biggest complaints of people who are career women and career people because they're not able to think of different words. They're not able to speak properly. They're not able to have concentration and focus. And they used to be very focused and very powerful in their positions, and now they're not. Dizziness is a big problem, and the official name of that is posterior orthostatic tachycardia. And what happens is people are they're lying down, they're horizontal, and anytime they sit up or stand up, they get dizzy and many times faint. And there are many people who literally spend their lives in the horizontal position at home because they cannot sit up. But the hallmark, the actual defining of this symptom of this disease, calling it ME-CFS, is something called post-exertional malaise. And most people don't even know that terminology, and people who are sick with it call it PEM. And what that means is any type of exertion, be it physical or mental or emotional, brings on the symptoms that you have in a form of like a crash, meaning whatever you had is that much worse once you've done something very, very small. So you might have literally brushed your teeth, you might have taken a shower, and people are excited when they can take a shower once a week. And then what happens is a few hours later, or even within 24, 48 hours, they go into this crash and they have absolutely no energy and can't get out of bed. And this can happen just because someone's feeling a little bit better and they make a phone call. I was on the phone with somebody last week that this happened to. She's very severe. Every now and then she can get out of the house and go do her marketing. And she called me and she said, I actually have to get off the phone. I can't talk anymore. And she's crashed for a week. Some people are crashed for months just from doing something very little like this. We actually have no idea why this happens, but this happens with this disease. So this is a problem of huge, huge global problem. So I'm really glad that you're here today to talk about it and to really understand that if you do know somebody with these symptoms, they are real, they're not lazy, they're not trying to not work, they're really wanting to get back to life, and they really have a biological disease. Thank you.